Now, massive MIMO. So it is important that you stay connected with me to the last of the video, and if you are watching this video on YouTube, please click on the red subscribe button and bell button to enable the email notification. If watching this video on Facebook, then please click to like and follow the page. Now, massive MIMO. First question is comes, why massive MIMO? We use very high frequency signal in 5G. High frequency means size of single antenna will be very small. That means their aperture size will be very small. That means we can say antenna area of receiving energy will be very small. To overcome this issue in high frequency by using larger number of transmission antenna. You can see here distance between the transceiver antenna and receiving antenna is R. Received power is inversely proportional to the square of the distance from the transmission antenna. That means PRX equal to PTX by 4 pi R square. R is the distance between TX and RX antenna. If distance get increased by 2 times away, then received power get a decrease by 4 times. In real scenario, we know that received signal power is also affected by frequency and received antenna gain. Means PRX equal to PTX by 4 pi R square, lambda square 4 pi into GRX. GRX is the received antenna gain. Here I have told affected by frequency means if frequency increase, the wavelength will decrease. If wavelength will decrease, the received signal power will decrease. So received signal power will affected by frequency and receive antenna gain. As a mathematically formula is PTX by 4 pi R square, lambda square 4 pi into GRX. We can see here received power is proportional to the square of the distance, a square of the wavelength. Received power is the proportional to the square of the wavelength. If in example, we can say if we assume antenna gain doesn't change and frequency get a increase by 2 times. If frequency get increased by 2 times, that means wavelength will also be decreased by 2 times. That means wavelength get decreased by 2 times, that means lambda now become a lambda by 2. That means receiving power will decrease by 4 times. Lambda by 2, that means power, receiving power will decrease by 4 times. In another example, if we use 3 GHz frequency in current communication and now we use 30 GHz frequency in 5G, wavelength in 30 GHz is 10 times shorter than 3 GHz. Because frequency is increased by 10 times, then wavelength will be decreased also by 10 times. It means receive power at 30 GHz will be 100 times receive power. Receive power at 30 GHz will be 100 times lower than the receive power at 3 GHz. Now, receive power become 100 times lower. So what need to do here? If we will multiply here by 100 times, then receive power will maintain, right? So we can resolve this issue by multiplying 100 times. So we will add another parameter. This is transmitter antenna gain. In that situation, it will get more complicated because not only receiver antenna gain but also transmitter antenna gain play the role to increase receive signal power. So now GRX and GTX both will play the role to maintain the receive signal power. Here our problem is lambda square by 4 pi. If high frequency, then wavelength will small and receive signal power will also be decreased. So this is the main problem. Then what is the solution? Solution is GRX into GTX. Increase TX power, yeah, increase TX and RX antenna. If increase the TX and RX antenna, due to this, massive MIMO is implemented. Now here is the simple formula to calculate the network throughput. Throughput is depend on this parameter, this factor, cell density, available spectrum, spectral efficiency, if we are going to increase demand data, we have this different factor to increase the throughput. First is cell density. Cell density refer to the number of cell per unit volume. If you want to increase the cell density, that really means that you put up more base station. We are putting more base stations in distance of 100 meter to 200 meter. But it is expensive to deploy more base station. Second is available spectrum. We can increase the frequency spectrum, yeah, increase the bandwidth that we are using. And problem is that the frequency that we are using today for cellular communications, we are using many 100 megahertz for different type of cell network. And different application like TV broadcasting, we use for millimeter wave technology, and it is a great technology for short range communications. Next is spectrum efficiency, bit per second per hertz per user. If number of antenna will increase, spectral efficiency also will increase. As per this formula, if we record the throughput in 5G, if suppose that available spectrum is increased by 10 times and cell density will also be increased by 10 times and the spectral efficiency is increased by 5 times, then network throughput will be increased by 500 times. In case of one antenna, you can see here in color, you can see here in yellow, green, blue, indicating how strong the signal is discharged at zero. You can see here at zero it is showing and below is minus 40. Then how it show that how signal is discharged at zero, and then it become a weaker and weaker, so it's down to minus 40 dB of the path loss. And in first figure we have only one antenna, and you see from this shape the signal is propagating equal in all direction, so there is no direction, no activity of the signals. If we go for the m is equal to 8, that means when we'll go for the 8 antenna, and now we are sending signal toward this user, we can create this type of beam focused toward the user. The signal is stronger around the users from the array, and this is called a mean lobe, and there is also some side lobe that contain the substantial interference. Maybe the signal in this lobe is 8 times stronger than in other direction. If we are going to more antenna like m equal to 64 antenna, then signal become a more and more narrow and more focused like a laser toward the users, and here you can see side lobe, they are much smaller, so it is showing less leakage in other direction. Same as here you can see for the 4x4, 8x8 and 60x60 antenna, their beam is changed, beam focus is changed. For 4x4 the lobe is more dense, and 8x8 it become a little narrow, but side lobe is there. For 60x60 mean lobe, beam become more narrow, and the side lobe is leakage decreases. So this is the differences of the massive MIMO. If antenna will increase, then their spatial efficiency will increase. Now we will see the beam management, how beam management works. Here you can see from A and B, figure A and B, and also I am working with another topic of 5G and LT in depth. So please हमारे channel से जुड़े रहें. अगर आप इस video को YouTube पे देख रहे हैं और मेरे channel पे नए हैं, तो इसे subscribe कर लें और इसके बगल में एक bell button होगा, उस पर क्लिक करके email notification को enable कर लें. अगर इस video को Facebook पर देख रहे हैं, तो please page को like and follow कर लें. अगर आपको कोई query है, तो नीचे comment box में comment करें. अगर आपको video पसंद आया है, तो please like कर लें. So thanks for watching this video. Bye, take care.